was, I don't know, 15, I've been basically in the gym. Anytime I've strayed away from boxing, self-sabotage vices have crept in and the devil's been on my shoulder whispering some what seemed like good ideas at the time. I've been fighting now for, I think, 21, 22 years. All I do is train and fight. It's a good routine for me. So without boxing, I have absolutely no idea where I'd be, but I can't see a positive ending. And it definitely wouldn't be a successful path without boxing in my life. So the hay fight got proposed to me, and the money was astronomical, and I negotiated even more. So it seemed like the opportunity I've been waiting for. I was ranked in the top 10 by the WBA. That was like a dream come true. And then they mentioned O2 Arena, sold out crowds, David Hay. I mean, the stage was set. Everything was there for me to shine. But unfortunately for me, I was a complete disaster. So after the Hay fight, I've had eight wins, eight by knockout. I've been fighting journeymen. I fought in Austria, Slovenia, Croatia, Bosnia, Germany. I went to Nigeria for a fight, got cancelled on the day. So I've just been travelling around, taking some fights. I haven't been doing any media, promoting myself much. I just wanted to get back in the ring and see how I felt. And I'm in good shape now. My reflexes are there. The thing is, my hand speed, my reflexes, my defence, things like that had to come back, because after the first couple of fights, the way I was performing, I was really just, nothing had changed. I would still lose to Hay in 1 minute the way I was fighting. But now I'm in good shape, and I've received some really big offers now. We've got a really big offer in America. So after eight fights, eight knockouts, and a couple of years of steady training and diet, I think I'm ready to try again. So I met 𝚏𝚊𝚌𝚘𝚘𝚔 in Germany at a fight show. And then we kept in touch, mainly as friends, and then he called me one day and said he's building a boxing team, a boxing team in Germany, would I like to be a part of it? And I said, well, you know, let's talk about the details, the financial side. And I went to meet the guys from Ugro, the sponsors, the trainers, the boxers, and I really liked it. So I've been with them now about 1 year. They've been managing me in some of these comeback fights, and with them, yeah, I enjoy it. It's good to be part of a team, to be part of something, not just in the gym by myself for the rest of my career. I mean, for so many years I just trained by myself with nobody, just in the garage or in the gym, so it gets pretty boring. So it's nice to be part of a team, and they're doing big events now, they're signing big fighters, so I'm glad I'm with the Ugro team. So I'll be fighting December 14 in Oberhausen in Germany, and that I'll be the main event. So it's great to be back to main event status in these countries. And I think I'll be fighting a 10 rounder, some sort of title fight. So that'll be my first 10 rounder on the comeback, test my stamina. And then after that, I've been offered a very big contract by a promoter in America. And we're talking huge money. The money in America now is bigger than it's ever been. Really insane amounts of money being thrown around in boxing now, and they've offered me a very large deal, and I had many big names chasing me, and the money just kept going up, 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 up. And so it's almost like the more I said no and give me more money, they just kept throwing another 10, 20, 30,000 on top. And now I've got a really big offer to go back to America and back to the big time, so it's a chance for me not only to make a lot of money, but to try and end my career with more positive experiences than the David Hay fight. I don't train as much as other guys. I'm more of a power athlete. I'm lifting weights. I lift weights less than most of the top world champions I've trained with. A lot of people, because of my physique, think I lift a lot of weights. I lift less than the guys in Oxnard, California I trained with the Tyson Fury camp I trained with. I'm lifting a lot less. My training is based on Charlie Francis, coach of Ben Johnson, 100 meter sprinter champion. So my training is based around explosive power. So when I'm in the gym, I'm trying to replicate what those guys did. And it's not about looking good, it's not bodybuilding. It's about pure brute force, speed, and power. Heavyweight boxing is about rendering your opponent unconscious and doing as much damage as possible. Remember back in the day when you taught me to live and I taught you to pray. We went in a battle together, no matter the weather, we never delayed. I never let you get astray, I never thought I'd see a day that you would come and betray me. Sick of playing silly games, you never love me anyway. You should not have let me get away, cause now I'm hunting for my prey. Let up and try to break me down and I'ma just get up there. Ask me how I did it, I'ma just tell them I rose up. Fight for my life. Coming back stronger. I will arise. I'm a survivor. Fight for my life. Coming back stronger. I will arise. Here to win. I just came here to end. So I'm training with Domagoj Ostojic and Marko Vucevic. Domagoj focusing on the technique, the strategy as the main trainer. Marko like a training partner and sparring partner. And I met both these guys just while I was living in Split and sort of became friends in the gym and I could see that they were serious guys when it came to training. Marko turned up for sparring with me, took some punches and didn't hesitate to come back every day and never complain. And since then he's become a WBF international champion and become one of the best sparring partners I've had in my life. And Butso has an amazing boxing brain. He's from a kickboxing and taekwondo background, but he's fascinated by boxing. So he completely understands boxing plus the American style of boxing. I'm not interested in the Soviet hit and run and clinch Klitschko style of boxing. It's never going to suit me. I'm a power athlete. I'm looking to get in there, score the knockout, be entertaining. I'm never going to be able to jab and run and hold. So that European style, it's not appealing to me. It's not appealing to the fans. So Ostojic is training me the way I like to train, which is a lot of big power shots, explosive punches. And Marko's, he can read me so well that he can spar with me every day and never take any big punches because he can predict me and he knows his way around the ring. So for me, it's a perfect training team. We don't get any injuries. We all have fun and we work really hard. Specific training, no cross training, no long runs, but specific boxing training. And so far results are, I'm 37 and I honestly think that I'm still as fast as I ever was. I'm stronger than I was and I'm actually enjoying it for the first time in my life.
Thank you.